So here's a quick case study on the Nemko implementation of Docmo. They're using Docmo to create their quotes, their project plans, and to email these files out. So I've whipped up a quick diagram here of the workflow, but first, let's just imagine Docmo is not in the picture. So the sequence starts with the users. They get information from the salespeople like, okay, we are going to certify a server for sale in China from these manufacturers. Okay, once they have that information, they go to a couple other spreadsheets and a database to gather the related information. Okay, what are the model numbers I need to use? What are the specs for China? What is all the other information we need on the manufacturer, etc.? Once they've gathered all the information, they then go select the right templates to fill out. They fill them out with copy-paste. They name them, they save them, and then they compose an email and attach those files to the email. Now, with Docmo in the picture, the sequence starts the same. The users get the information from the salespeople. They make the selection, we're certifying servers for sale in China, but then all the gathering of related information is automated. The selection of the right templates is automated. Obviously, the population of those templates and the composing of the emails and attaching those files to the emails is also automated. Now, with Docmo on the team, there's obviously a lot of improvements. First and foremost, the turnaround time. They're saving about 2 hours for every project. So the users are obviously just making a few selections, which brings us to the next point. Accuracy is almost perfect with Docmo. Again, the only user interaction is making selections. So all this downstream activity is automated, and therefore there'll be no mistakes with that if two things are true. One, if the users made the right selections, and two, if the automation within Docmo, which we'll go over here in a moment on all these other sheets, all the configuration and setup, if all that is correct, accuracy will be 100%. Which brings us to our last point, training. If your users are just making selections, training them is very simple. But in addition to that, imagine if your quoting procedures change, or maybe China changes their requirements. You'd need to hold a meeting with all your users and tell them, okay, this is how you do the quotes now. If you're doing servers for China, you need to add this content to those documents. But with Docmo, you don't need to even hold that meeting. And let me tell you why. Nancy is our main point of contact with Nemko, and she's kind of sitting over here next to the users. She doesn't use Docmo, but she configures it to work correctly for her users. So when China changes their requirements, Nancy makes the necessary changes, and that's it. Her users don't change their behavior, so you don't have to train them on anything. So in the third video of this case study, I'll go over what Nancy actually does to change the configuration to accommodate these changes. But to finish this video, let me just give you a brief overview of what all these sheets are. So the users only interact with the dashboard. This is where they make their selections, and in their workbooks, we actually hide all the other sheets. Nancy, however, uses all the sheets because she's making the configurations. The black sheets hold all the imported information from the database and all the other spreadsheets. Once it's here, we can use this information for content, etc. Files is where you register your templates and define how to name them and where to save them. You can also reference content from other documents. Tags is basically your data mapping. This address goes here, use this calculation if these conditions are met, format this content, populate this table or image, all that. And emails is where you register your email templates. What is the subject? What is the body? What are the attachments? Who do we send it to? So that wraps up this video. Next, we'll go over the user workflow.